In this video, I am going to explain anatomical relationship between suboccipital muscles and nervous tissues. I explained basic anatomy of suboccipital muscles for another video, so this is kind of review, okay? Suboccipital muscles include four muscles. 1, 2, 3, 4. Number one is rectus capitis posterior minor. Rectus capitis posterior minor. This is number one. Number two is rectus capitis posterior major. Rectus capitis posterior major. That's number two. Number three, this one is obliquus capitis superior. Capitis superior. Number four, this one is obliquus capitis inferior. Obliquus capitis inferior. Okay, these four muscles together, they are called suboccipital muscles or suboccipital. Okay, now let me explain relationship with nervous tissue. Here we go, these are nervous tissue. I want you to focus on this nerve. This is greater occipital nerve. Greater occipital nerve. This nerve emerges from above the level of C2. This nerve is very important for neck pain and headache, especially around posterior part. So when people complain they have headache on backside, most likely this nerve is affected. Not always, but highly included. Okay, now this greater occipital nerve and suboccipital muscles are very, very close. There are many neck muscles around here. Of course, these superficial muscles have also relationship with greater occipital nerve, but suboccipital muscles are kind of closer than superficial muscles to greater occipital nerve. So oftentimes, both greater occipital nerve and suboccipital muscles get tied together. This reason can be varied, like from concussion or from car accident, whiplash, head trauma. Right, there are various reasons that these two tissues get tight, but oftentimes these two structures get tight simultaneously. Okay, so greater occipital nerve and suboccipital muscles, very strong connection. Now let me explain connection from suboccipital to inside part of vertebra. Okay, there is one key muscle in suboccipital, which is this one. It's kind of hard to see. This one. This is rectus capitis posterior minor. Okay? This is very close to inside part of vertebra, but it does not mean this muscle connects to inside part directly. It has connection indirectly, but how? Okay, there is one another tissue that kind of connects between rectus capitis posterior minor and inside part of vertebra. This is it. This is acetabulo-occipital membrane. Acetabulo-occipital membrane. This connective tissue connects occiput and C1. C1 is also known as Atlas. Atlas. That's why its name is atlanto-occipital membrane. Makes sense, right? So, rectus capitis posterior minor, atlanto-occipital membrane, then this membrane connects to membrane of spinal cord, which is dura mater. Dura mater. Dura mater is membrane that surrounds spinal cord. Okay? This connection is very important. Its connection is like from outside to inside. That's very important connection. Then, if you follow connection of membrane, you can go to inside part of head, because this membrane is continuous. Let's say this is spinal cord. What is above spinal cord? There is brain. It's continuation. That is why membrane is also continued. Does it make sense? So if you can access here, you can approach to dura mater indirectly. I don't say you can touch dura mater directly, but you can go to inside indirectly. Okay, this is very important connection. If you know how to approach to suboccipital, maybe you can go inside part of vertebra via rectus capitis posterior minor. Does it make sense? Then you might have effect for dura mater. Yay, this is very, very important. Then, what is below cervical spines? There are thoracic spines, lumbar spines, and sacrum. Let's check this kind of relationship. Okay, where is suboccipital? That's about here. Then atlanto-occipital membrane. Then you can go inside part of vertebra. You can follow connection to inside part of cranium. Does it make sense? Then you can, of course, follow connection all the way down to sacrum. If you know how to access to sacrum or lumbar spines, go ahead. That's very efficient, right? You don't have to approach from here. But if you think about connection of membrane, you can approach this membranous connection from here. But as I said, you know how to work on sacrum and lumbar spines, go ahead. That's going to be more efficient. Speaking of membranous connection, maybe you can connect to anywhere from this point. I don't say this is the only point that you can access inside part of head. It's not, but this is good to know. Even though you are not therapist, maybe you are a personal trainer, you are yoga teacher, Pilates teacher, maybe you can focus about upper cervical spines and have a visualization there is connection. Maybe you can affect inside part of vertebra and head. Okay, this connection is not only for therapists. This may be good for body worker. I hope this video helps your new idea for your career. If you liked today's video, please hit the like button, comment, and subscribe. See you next video.